The positions and Euclidean positions, the question asks to find x if this is a row matrix, an order 3 matrix, and column matrix. From here, question asks to find, and this is the application of matrix multiplication. If you are getting the matrix multiplication concept, you can get easily. Okay, let me solve these questions and I will explain during solving these questions. Okay, now let me start. Now let me do directly from there. Okay, I have listed how to get the matrix multiplication. Row multiply with column. Okay, first row multiply with first column, give the first element. Second column, give second element. Third column, third element. We already learned. If you have matrix multiplication doubt, please go to the first sessions of this chapters. Okay. Now, 1 multiply 1 is 1, 1 multiply 1 is 1, plus multiply plus is plus, x multiply 2 is 2x, then plus multiply plus is plus, 1 multiply 15. Now, first row completely multiply with first column gives the one set of elements. Now first row multiply with second column in the another set of element, that means 1 multiply 3, x multiply 5x, then 1 multiply 3, then again in third column in the third element, then 1 multiply 2, x multiply 1x, then 1 multiply 2. Now there is no other row, this guy there is only single. Okay, it is the other zoom and we will get the next line. Now, and the next term is 1, 2, x equals to 0. Now, give the sum of like terms. 16 plus 2x, then 6 plus 5x, then 4 plus x. 1, 2, x, then equals to 0. Now again multiply. Row multiply with column. There is one row, one column means one set of elements. Then 16 plus 2x multiply with 1. 16 plus 2x. Then plus x, 6 plus 10x multiply with 2. 12 plus 10x. Okay, 6 plus 5x multiply with 2. 2, 6 is 12, 2, 5 is 10. Now 4 plus x multiply with x, 4x plus x square. Now x square, then 2x, 10x, 12x, 16x, then almost 28 plus 98 equals to 0. Now, what kind of equation? This is factorization. Do the factorization to get the value of x. Okay, from here. Okay, from here, please complete by yourself. Okay, this is your home task over here because we already learned how to get the factorization in our classes. That's why you use your own basic concept and solve from here and tell me whether you got answer or not. Okay, please comment your answer. I'd like to hear whether your answer is right or wrong.
Okay, now let me see the next question.
Okay, next questions. And now this is a very, very important questions. These type of questions you will get in board exam. Again, to if a equals to 1, 1, 1, order 2 matrix, prove that a to the power n is equal to 2 to the power n minus 1, to the power n minus 1, to the power n minus 1, to the power n minus it is true for all positive integers and or not. This type of questions every year we will get one question. This is very important type questions. To solve this type of questions, we will use principle of mathematical induction, which we learn in class 11. Okay, and there are three methods to solve this type of equations. First, we have to use n equals to 1 and check it whether it is true or not. If it is true, then we will further proceed. Okay, then further, we will assume ourselves n equals to k is true. K n equals to k equals to true. K means it is greater than 1. After assuming that n equals to true, then we have to show n equals to k k plus 1 is true or not. Okay, there are three steps there. Okay, we have to solve one by one. First step, proving. Second step, assuming. Third step, proving. Okay, first step, proving. Second step, assuming. Third step, proving. Okay, now let me explain by solving this question, and this is very, very important. Now, for n equals to 1, for n equals to 1, e to the power 1, we are using here, and this is 2, 1 minus 1, and that is equals to 1 minus 1 is 0. Any number power 0 is always 1. Any number power 0 is 1, 1, 1, 1. That means A1 means A, A to the power 1 means A, A equals to almost there 1, 1. That means we call the answer. That means it's true. For N equals to 1, this expression true, we call that A equals to 1, 1. So we got after using N equals to 1, we got A equals to 1, 1. That means it is true. Okay. After putting value N equals 1, this answer must be equals to A to the power answer. Because a to the power 1 means a, a equals to 1, 1, and how much they provided, a equals to 1, 1, that means how much is true for n equals to 1. This first step is over. First step is proving part, second step is assuming part. Okay? It is true for n equals to 1. Okay? Number 2, let it be true for n equals to k. Okay, what is k? K is more than 1. Okay, what is k? K is bigger than 1. It is assuming, how it is assuming ourselves, it is true for n equals to k. That means now we are going to replace this n, all n by k. Okay, we are going to replace this all n by k. Now that is e to the power k equals to almost e to the power k minus 1. To the power k minus 1, to the power k minus 1, to the power k minus 1. Okay, now this is assuming part. First part proving, we have to prove it. Second part, ourselves, we have to assume it is true. Now third part, proving part is there. Now, n equals to k plus 1. Now, replace in this expression and all n by k plus 1. Now, let's see what we get. A to the power k plus 1 is equals to the power k plus 1 minus 1 to the power k plus 1, we are replacing n by k plus 1 and minus 1 is already there, and to the power k plus 1 minus 1 to the power k plus 1 minus 1. Okay, we have to get this expression, or this expression means we can write in short form to the power k to the power k, to the power k, to the power k. Okay, we have to solve this one. By using this left hand side, we have to solve right hand side. Okay? By using this left hand equation, we have to solve right hand side equation. If you call this equation, that means our answer we prove it. Okay? This is the last step to prove whether this is true or not. Okay? By using left hand side k plus 1, we have to prove this right hand side. Okay, now let me do here. Left hand side, what is there? A to the power k plus 1. Can you break this power? Yes, we already learned in lower class how to break this is a to the power k into a to the power 1. Now, substitute the value of a to the power k. What is the value of a to the power k? This is the value of a to the power k. Substitute to use this value. Then, in place of a to the power k, what we are going to use? A to the power k plus 2. To the power k minus 1, to the power k minus 1, to the power k minus 1, to the power k minus 1. Then what is a to the power 1 or a? What is a to the power 1 or a? A to the power 1 means a. Same thing is there. 1, 1, 1, 1. Now use the matrix multiplications and try to get this right hand side. If you got right hand side, means our answer part over. Okay, our proving part is over. We got done. We proved the. So, okay, now use the matrix multiplication and multiply it. Now, 2 to the power k minus 1 into 1, 2 to the power k computing power k minus 1 into 1. Then again, row multiplied with column plus 2 to the power k minus 1. Okay. Now first row completely multiplied. First column is one set of element. Now first row with second. 2 to the power k minus 1 plus 2 to the power k minus 1. Same way we will get everything same. 2 to the power k minus 1. 2 to the power k minus 1. 2 to the power k minus 1 plus 2 to the power k minus 1. Okay, now these terms are same. Apple plus apple, we can write 2 apple. Apple plus apple, we can write 2 apple. Apple plus apple, we can write 2 apple. Then this is equals to 2 into 2 to the power k minus 1. And this is also 2 into 2 to the power k minus 1. 2 into 2 into 2 to the power k minus 1. 2 into 2 to the power k minus 1. If you multiply, if the multiply is there, any other power, suppose there is a multiplied to the power n, that means according to the multiplication power formula, we can use this one n plus 1. Okay, same thing, there is base are same, we can add the power. In multiplication, if the base are same, we can add the power. Power 1 is there, 1 is there, that means this is equals to 2 to the power k minus 1 plus 1. 2 to the power k minus 1 plus 1. 2 to the power k minus 1 plus 1. 2 to the power k minus 1 plus 1. We got the right hand side. Okay? If you after using the left hand side, you got the right hand side, means we put the answer. Now we write the conclusion. Conclusion. Therefore, from the principle of mathematical induction. Okay, from the principle of mathematical induction, it is true for all n belongs to n. Okay, n means integer, positive integers. What is I? I means positive integers. Okay, positive integers. Okay. Okay, this is the very important type questions, and also many questions are there in your textbook, and use the same concept and try to solve other questions. Okay, this is the important, every year you will get one of the questions, this type of questions in your board exam. Okay, we will wait next.